In earlier mathematics that you may have done, you probably got familiar with the idea of a factor. So for example, let me just pick an arbitrary number, the number 12. We could say that the number 12 is the product of, say, 2 and 6. 2 times 6 is equal to 12. So because if you take the product of 2 and 6, you get 12, we could say that 2 is a factor of 12. We could also say that 6 is a factor of 12. You take the product of these things, you get 12. You could even say that this is 12 in factored form. People don't really talk that way, but you could think of it that way, that we broke 12 into the things that we could use to multiply it. And you probably remember from earlier mathematics the notion of prime factorization, where you break it up into all of the prime factors. So in that case, you could break the 6 into a 2 and a 3, and you have 2 times 2 times 3 is equal to 12. And you would say, well, this would be 12 in prime factored form, or the prime factorization of 12. So these are the prime factors. And so the general idea, this notion of a factor, or is things that you can multiply together to get your original thing. Or if you're talking about factored form, you're essentially taking the number and you're breaking it up into the things that when you multiply them together, you get your original number. What we're going to do now is extend this idea into the algebraic domain. So if we start with an expression, let's say the expression is 2 plus 4x. Can we break this up into the product of two either numbers or two expressions, or the product of a number and an expression? Well, one thing that might jump out at you is we could write this as 2 times 1 plus 2x. And you can verify, if you like, that this does indeed equal 2 plus 4x. 2 times, we're just going to distribute the 2. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times 2x is equal to 4x. So plus 4x. And so in our algebra brains, this will often be viewed as or referred to as this expression factored, or in a factored form. And in this case, or sometimes people would say that we have factored out the 2. But you could just as easily say that you have factored out a 1 plus 2x. You've broken this thing up into two of its factors. So let's do a couple of examples of this. And then we'll think about, I just told you that, hey, we could write it this way, but how would you actually figure that out? So let's do another one. Let's say that you had, I don't know, let's say you had 6, let me just in a different color. Let's say you had 6x plus 30. That's interesting. So one way to think about it is, can we break up each of these terms so that they have a common factor? Well, this one over here, I can literally, 6x literally represents 6 times x. And then 30, if I want to break out a 6, 30 is divisible by 6, so I can write this as 6 times 5. 30 is the same thing as 6 times 5. And when you write it this way, you see, hey, I can factor out a 6. Essentially, this is the reverse of the distributive property. So I'm essentially undoing the distributive property, taking out the 6, and you are going to end up with, so if you take out the 6, you end up with 6 times, so if you take out the 6 here, you have an x, and you take out the 6 here, you have plus 5. So 6x plus 30, if you factor it, we could write it as 6 times x plus 5. And you can verify with the distributive property, if you distribute this 6, you get 6x plus 5 times 6, or 6x plus 30. Now let's do something that's a little bit more interesting, where we might want to factor out a fraction. So let's say we had the situation, let me get a color, a new color here. So let's say we had 1 half minus 3 halves minus 3 halves x. How could we write this in a, I guess you could say, in a factored form, or if we wanted to factor out something? And I encourage you to pause the video and try to figure it out. And I'll give you a hint. See if you can factor out 1 half. Well, so let's write it that way. If we're trying to factor out 1 half, we can write this first term as 1 half times 1. And this second one we could write as, so minus 1 half times 3x. That's what this is. 3 halves x is the same thing as 3x divided by 2, or 1 half times 3x. And then here we could see that we could just factor out the 1 half, and you're going to have 1 half times 1 minus 3x. Another way you could have thought about it is, hey, look, both of these are products involving 1 half. And I know it's a little bit more confusing when you're dealing with a fraction here. But one way to think about it is, I can divide out a 1 half from each of these terms. So if I divide out a 1 half from this, 1 half divided by 1 half is 1. And if I take 3 halves and I divide it by 1 half, that's going to be 3. And so I took out a 1 half. That's another way to think about it. I don't know if that confuses you more or confuses you less, but hopefully this gives you the sense of what factoring an expression is. And I'll do another example where we're even using more abstract things. So I could say ax plus ay. How could we write this in factored form? Well, these are both of these terms have products of a in it. So I could write this as a times x plus y. And sometimes you'll hear people say, you have factored out the a, and you can verify it. If you multiply this out again, if you distribute the a, you'd be left with ax plus ay.